And here we go, folks. And playback and action.
Hey, this is Adam from Counting Crows, obviously. And I'm here on the set of the You Can't Count On Me video. We're filming it. You'll hear a lot of noise in the background. That's because they're making a video over there. In fact, I'll probably have to go over there in a minute. I got a break right now, so I decided to answer some of these questions that fans have written in and asked.
Anything's hard to change, but hey, I got you down on your knees again.
You Can't Count On Me was really, really difficult. We had to try it a lot of different ways. It was written as a really pretty acoustic song, but never intended to be one. So we started off playing it as this big electric song, but the drums were really boomy and made it into an arena rock song, and that was all wrong. So then we stripped it down and played it as a really acoustic song, and that was just boring, and it didn't make the song happen, because the song has to be about contradictions, how things are sad and that makes them beautiful, but how that's like a trap. And because, you know, good guy or not, sad memories or not, hurting is hurting, and this song really needs to make a point that inside all those beautiful lyrics is someone who keeps hurting people. And so there needs to be a sort of violence, and the acoustic version didn't work.
Well, I mean, there must be some use for an enormous copper hole in the floor.
I went out to dinner and I came back and everyone was gone except for Jim and Brian. And they had found this little room in the recording studio and they had set a really, really simple drum kit up. And what it allowed them to do was you could beat the crap out of the drums. And they didn't get big. Once we figured that out, like I was like, where's Millard? And we called the hotel and like woke Millard up and got him back in the studio. And Millard and Jim and I got in that room together and we played that song like a bunch of times with Millard and I like getting as loud and almost screaming our parts out to get Jim to like go over the top. And it was just the piano and bass drums and me. And we recorded this wild like version of the song. And then the next day everyone else came in and we said, okay, play to this. And we, you know, at that point we just went, you know, turned the piano off too and said, okay, you guys have bass, drum, and vocals, play to this.
Can't count on me.
It was very satisfying to kind of figure that out. It was hard after that too because it was missing something. We couldn't figure out what it was. It was still missing some kind of punch. And Dan was working on one of the other songs with this guitar sound and it wasn't working. And I suddenly thought, hey, can we go back to You Can't Count On Me and let's use that sound. He had some crappy little amp and it was making the guitar distort. Like a replacement song or something. And I said, what if we put that really ugly guitar sound on You Can't Count On Me and you beat the crap out of your guitar on all the big moments? And we put that over it and that really was the final ingredient. And we had him attack that guitar, but it needed that drums and bass and guitar violence to make the rest of it work. Otherwise, it was too samey. It's a song about contradictions, and if you don't have both sides of it in there, it doesn't make any sense. It's complex enough as it is without, you know, you need the music to make it clear.
Okay. What sound is the elevator on?
Oh, please with me on one.
Okay.
Sometimes I do really intense things.
Yes, please.
Like that.